This is Space Ace's Landing Party, a small card game of big tactics and strategy. It is playable with 2 to 3 players, and up to 4 can play by shuffling 2 decks together. Each round takes about 10 minutes, and most games last 2 to 3 rounds, making it perfect for playing on a lunch break at the pub or as a quick game with friends. The premise of Landing Party is that your crew has been given a mandate to seek out new planets, and you have just discovered a beautiful one. But uh-oh, another starship is here too, and they want the credit for claiming this planet. It's time to send down a landing party to see who gets to win the coveted Certificate of Discovery. These are on the back of every planet card. Inside the box, you will find 18 unique crew members, 3 cadets, and 8 special guests, each with a rank and unique special ability. To set up for your first game, remove the cadets. You won't need these until later rounds. Also, remove all the special guest cards. These are indicated by an asterisk next to their name. In advanced variations, you can shuffle in a couple special guests for more variety and replayability. But your first few dozen or 100 games, there's plenty to work with in the standard deck of crew members. Next, you place 2 crew members face down in the brig. These are considered out of play. You don't know who they are, they did something wrong last round, and they're out of play for this mission. Also, place 2 crew members face up on shore leave. They're on vacation for this mission, and they're also out of play, but you do know who they are. In this way, the game becomes one of almost complete information, except for the 2 crew members in the brig, and what combinations are available changes every time. Deal the remaining crew members to each player. These will be the crew that are on board your ship. Next, each player picks a crew member from their ship to place in their transporter buffer. Buffered crew members are hidden from the prying eyes of cards like the telepath, the navigator, and the tactician, and they'll come into play later. Players take turns beaming down crew members of equal or higher rank than the previous one in command of the landing party. So, for example, a telepath can take command from a nurse because her rank is higher. And a navigator can take command from a telepath because they have an equal rank. Crew members have 2 statuses when they're on the planet. When they're upright, they are considered active. When they are sideways, they are considered stunned. Active crew members have the rank printed on their card. Stunned crew members have a rank of 0 and are considered to have no special abilities. Some special abilities require you to stun a crew member after beaming them down to activate it, like the captain, creating an interesting choice. Do you keep the rank or use the powerful ability? The various special abilities interact differently with other crew members if they are stunned or active, like a red shirt that can revive a stunned crew member and put them in command by stunning himself. There's a lot to discover here in a surprising amount of depth. Cards like the Navigator let you place a crew member in your ship into your shuttle if you can guess the crew member on board an opponent's starship. This is indicated by placing the card face down in front of you. Crew in your shuttle must beam down to the planet and take command of the landing party on your next turn, regardless of their rank or what their special ability says. The last mechanic to bear in mind is your starship. You can activate your starship once per mission on your turn by flipping it over. Activating the starship fires the phasers and stuns the current crew member in command of the planet. So if you don't have a card you can play, this is your get-out-of-jail-free option once. The card in command is stunned. You beam up the buffered crew member into your hand, and your turn ends immediately. If a player cannot beam a new crew member to the planet or activate their starship, they lose, and the opponent claims the Certificate of Discovery for that planet. Shuffle up the cards and set it up again for the next mission on a new planet, except this time, the previous winner has to take on a cadet into their ship that takes the place of a normal crew member, placing them at a severe disadvantage on the next round. Get 2 certificates to win the game. And that's Space Ace's Landing Party. The rules are simple, but there's so much to unpack here with how the cards interact with each other, plus a plethora of special guests to shuffle in and add new dynamics and replayability. It's truly outstanding for such a small game. Hope you enjoyed this walkthrough. Now get playing.